Welcome everyone to Defender for Cloud in the Field. As I promised, we have a new episode with a lot of things and things that we announced at Microsoft Secure recently as a follow-up from our previous session. But before we start, I just want to say thanks again for all the subscribers. And if you are not subscribed to the Microsoft Secure channel, make sure to use the AKA link below. That is the AKA link for our playlist, where you will find all Defender for Cloud episodes in there. Now, today we are going to continue our conversation about Defender CSPM. And part of this new plan, there is something called data security posture management from the data perspective. And no one better to talk about this than the product manager that work directly with this product. And I'm very glad to have him here today. Tzach Kaufmann, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Yuri. Pleasure to be here.
It's a pleasure to have you here, my friend. Tell us a little bit more what you do for Microsoft.
Well, I've joined Microsoft to help bring the data aware security product to life. This is our first release. I'm really, really excited. Joined Microsoft last September. So new to Microsoft, and again, really, really excited. We have a wonderful product that we just released.
Absolutely, and we are glad to have you here. And this is such an amazing journey that we are starting with this product, which is part of Defender for Cloud overall Synapse solution. But let's talk about, in particular, data-aware secure posture. So what is that?
Sure. So data-aware security posture is first release of adding data insights into our CSPM and into our Defender for Storage solution. So essentially, we have a lot of insights on the infrastructure, like is there a breach happening, identifying malware, is there some misconfiguration on your cloud posture? And by adding data-aware capabilities to those products, essentially we are helping you to prioritize the risk of your resources. So, for example, we are telling you if on a specific storage resource you have sensitive data. And that helps you to prioritize that you first need to address any issues that you have with that specific storage in comparison with other storages that might not contain sensitive information.
This is an excellent approach, because we heard so many times from customers asking us to help them to prioritize the remediation of the resources, and data sensitivity scenario is a big one. So I'm glad that we are bringing all those insights to help customers prioritize what is important to them. Now, when it comes to the onboarding experience, how is the onboarding experience? I know you have a demo later, so don't worry about it. We're going to demonstrate that. But just give an overview about the onboarding experience.
Sure. So customers were very clear in when we spoke with them in terms of what it will take to start and adding, onboarding their resources, the environment, to be able to identify if they have sensitive data. They wanted something that will be transparent as possible. And we took a lot of effort and done a lot of background work to make sure that the onboarding is as low friction as possible. Essentially, and we're going to see that, to be able to identify all your resources, all your storage resources and database resources, and identify what kind of sensitive data there are on those resources, it's just a flip of a switch. Just change the toggle from disable and enable. We're going to see that. And in about a day or 2 days, you'll get all the results on what's going on within your data estate.
So there is no agent installation per se?
No agent required. Yeah, exactly.
Okay. When it comes to the sensitive labels, how that works. Do we discover things that are already configured? Does customer needs to have, for example, Microsoft Purview? Does customer have to have any other solution where they already classify the data and we are just discovering that?
Yeah, Yuri, I'm glad that you asked this question because this is a very important one. We know that our customers spent a lot of effort on their classification projects. So they went into surveys, understood what kind of information they have there, and then they used our Purview information protection to be able to identify the types of data that they have, either by creating labels, which consist of different kind of sensitive information types, but also they create their own custom sensitive information type to find specific information of their organization. We understand that that kind of effort is quite considerable, and to make sure that our customers will be able to continue using all of the effort that they did, we are connected directly to Microsoft Purview Information Protection and ingesting the various labels and the custom information types that was generated by the customers, and they can use it as part of our configuration to identify sensitive information, as I mentioned before, specific to their organization.
But just to be clear, because I know that this question comes a lot, we do not require customers to have Purview. Is that correct?
Important note. Yeah. There is an option to take advantage of Purview information protection, but it's not a must. Even if you don't have or don't use Microsoft Purview information protection, you can still use our built-in sensitive information type to scan for over 200 types of sensitive information.
Okay. So since we are on that subject of Purview, what is the difference between Purview and our data-aware secure posture?
Yeah, this is a question that we get a lot. Like customers say, okay, I have Purview. Does it mean that I don't need you, or is it replacing Purview? It needs to be clear that we have Microsoft Purview and MDC DataAware Security are completely different products. While Microsoft Purview is targeted at the compliance, governance, and risk, we are targeting the security admin. So essentially, we are looking into identify what kind of sensitive information you have, but we are not looking for all of the sensitive data that you have. We are just identifying enough sensitive information so the security admin can take a quick decision to mitigate the risk that is either going to happen or is already happening right now. So as a summary on what I just said, Purview is for compliance governance, scanning all your data estate, finding all your sensitive data. We are security oriented, identifying just enough sensitive information to let the security admin decide on what needed to be done to maintain the security posture.
That's great. Great clarification. I'm glad that we are going to this direction and adding value to the security administrator. Now, when it comes to multi-cloud, do we have support for multi-cloud? And if we do, what are some of the resource types that are supported by this solution?
Sure. So, yeah, our solution is multi-cloud. Currently, we are supporting Azure, of course, and we are also supporting AWS. On AWS, for the storage, we are currently looking at S3 buckets, but we are also looking at database, for example, RDS, etc., to identify all kind of data aware security. And we do have future plans to look at other cloud vendors.
Okay, that's good. So we start in already with a mentality that multi-cloud is a must, which is great because that's the direction that we are going. Now, you were talking previously about sensitive data scanning, and we even say that we use smart scanning capabilities. Can you elaborate more on how that scanning works?
Sure. So the whole concept of rethinking the whole sensitive data discovery came from our customer, from our security admin that we are speaking with, from all of our customers, most of our customers. What we discovered is that there is a shift in paradigm. In the past, the identification process of finding your sensitive data was part of the CIO team or the data architects. The move to the cloud changed that. And now we are getting from secure admin a need to identify sensitive data as well. Why? Because they need to prioritize the risk, as we mentioned before. But legacy scanning facilities took many weeks, months, even more than that, to identify all your data states, all your sensitive data in all the various locations. The security admin has different requirements. They need to find to identify as quickly as possible if a specific resource, cloud resource, is sensitive or not. To address those new that shift in paradigm and those new needs, we developed a new sampling-based scanning engine that allows the customer very quickly to identify if a specific resource is sensitive, contains sensitive data or not, and provide evidence on that specific sensitive data that we identified. But we are not scanning the entire data estate. As I mentioned, this is something that can be done by Purview. We are identifying enough information for the security admin to take immediate action and mitigate any risk.
Yeah, makes sense. Makes sense. And definitely adds a lot of value. I do have a couple of more questions, but I believe that those questions will be answered as you demonstrate the product. So let's switch to the demo and then you can show how to enable, how to onboard, and how the experience looks like.
Sure. Wonderful. So first thing is go over the data sensitivity, which is what customers are using to identify what kind of data they have. So part of the information, as I mentioned, is built in. So we already grouped for the customer we created some logic groups like finance, including all the sensitive information types that are related to finance that is repeating across our customers. Those groups, the finance, PII, credentials, and the other, which is all of our built-in 200 sensitive information types, are part of the product if you have Purview information protection or you don't. So you can just use those in both cases. If you do have Purview information protection, we will ingest the custom ones that you created and also be able to use the labels from Purview information protection. To remind everyone, the labels are a collection of sensitive information types that constitute a specific identification for you to identify if you have certain kind of information. So for example, confidential can be all my financial information and my PII in a specific label. I told you before that we are going to show you what it means to do, what it means to onboard. And to onboard the product, to enable the onboarding, the only thing you need to go is go into the plans. And when you enter the plan, you will identify the Defender for CSPM over here. And in the settings, the only thing you need to do, and currently it's on, is turn on the sensitive data discovery. That's it. You just need to toggle, put it on. We will automatically, in the background, scan your entire data estate, identify all your data resources, the storage and database, and start scanning them for sensitive data, currently just on the storage. And then we will show you, we will start showing you all the various information that we identified. So the first thing that the customer would do after we finished the scan, is go into the attack path. As a reminder, an attack path is a new capability released with Defender for CSPM, and it is a collection of high risk, high profile, a posture issue, misconfiguration that the customer need to address right now. Let's look at on the various capabilities that we had with Data Aware. So Data Aware is on, as I mentioned, it's related to storage, it relates to databases, but we also include data flows that we are going to look in a minute. So for example, the number one misconfiguration is an RDS snapshot that is publicly available. Let's look at the RDS snapshot. So what we see here, and this is, as I mentioned, a top misconfiguration, we see that there is a snapshot that is publicly available over here, and essentially anyone with an AWS account can identify and take this RDS snapshot, essentially creating an issue for the organization that shared it, either by mistake or by intention, in order to share data. Other recommendation that we identify is replication of data. So for example, if you have an S3 bucket that replicates a data to another S3 bucket that is exposed to the internet. We are also finding information on buckets, S3 buckets that are exposed to the internet and contain sensitive data, which is the low-hanging fruit, of course, in terms of something that most of our customers would like to understand if this is in fact occurring on their environment. Another attack path that is relating to a flow that is really difficult to identify without the attack path is a VM that has vulnerabilities, also exposed to the internet, and has a read permission, an identity on it, to a data store that has sensitive data. So we are looking at the attack path over here, identify the IP, the network address, and over here we can see the storage account. So if we click on the storage account, we can see on the inside the very sensitive information that is on that storage account. So by accessing the internet exposed IP, getting to the virtual machine that contains vulnerabilities, using the managed identity on that virtual machine, an attacker can gain access to this storage account that contains all this sensitive information. Now, this is really difficult to identify that you have within the organization. By using this attack path, immediately we are showing you that this issue. But we did the extra step to even help you identify what's going on by combining the attack path directly to the alerts on this VM. So on the info, I have a link to the alerts. Clicking on the alerts, it will take me into the alert pane on this specific storage, showing me everything that is happening over here. So we, for example, we are seeing that on this storage that is exposed, there's a malicious file uploaded to this storage account. And this could be an attack of a lateral movement, but because there is also sensitive information on this storage, it is even multiplied in terms of the risk, because someone can take this file, this malicious file that might be a malware, and it can also take sensitive information from this storage, pass it to some VM, and then that sensitive data that was copied might be exposed to the internet.
That was great. It's a great demonstration, Tzach. Thank you very much. So we have the data the data sensitivity can be used for insight, and it is used for insights to help the prioritization of the remediation and for the security means to take actions immediately. I really love that we even added a category for data sensitivity in the attack path. I think that helps a lot to narrow, right? Because you may have a lot of attack paths, so I want to narrow only for data sensitivity, and we are able to do that. Great exactly. Work there. Great insights. Any final consideration before we wrap?
Yeah, we will be more than happy to have you join and use our product. Feel free to contact us.
And talking about feedback, just a reminder that Defender CSPM is already GA. We GA'd Defender CSPM during Microsoft Secure. But yes. This feature specifically is still in public preview. Is that correct?
Yes, exactly. You're absolutely right.
All right. And you can test this. I'm going to put the link here of the user voice. So if you have any feedback, you can also share on the user voice. But there are many places in the UI where you can click and provide direct feedback as well. And the feedback that you provide in the UI goes straight to Tzach's team, and he can take action and improve the product. So Tzach, thank you very much for taking the time to record this today. I truly appreciate your time.
Thank you.
All right, everyone. That's a wrap for today's episode. Make sure to subscribe to our channel. Again, the playlist below. And stay tuned. We have a lot more to come.